feed my tilapia fish stock chicken feed, did this experiment actually yield positive results? Stay tuned. Hi everybody, welcome again to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. Welcome to my channel. My name is Raleigh. I'm a high school teacher and I have an aquaponics system at the back of my yard, and I also keep ornamental fish wherein which I breed them specifically for pet shop and for aquariums for persons who wishes to have them. Okay, so today's video is focused on my tilapia, right? Now, for the past couple of months, I've been sharing with you that I've actually switched my feed from normal local produce tilapia fish feed, right? I shared with you that I have been using AquaMax, right? And they come in different grades, in which I've actually shared that with you. Now, this feed, Jamaican locally produced tilapia fish feed, looks somewhat like chicken feed, right? And it also smells like Jamaican chicken feed. The difference is that it have this kind of fishy smell, and that's how some of the time the guys at the local agriculture, actually garden store, actually use to determine whether or not it is chicken feed or it is fish feed. So I fed my tilapia stock, I think it was these, yeah, I fed these tilapia stock, this tilapia stock, so yeah, language, with chicken feed for a while, and as I shared in one of my videos, they started to breed. I stopped, and I started again after that, but I just never gave an update. Okay, so this is the thing with feeding chicken feed to your tilapia fish. One, it's cheap and it's doable. It is something that has been done in parts of the world, even in Jamaica, where persons actually feed their tilapia stock chicken feed, right? It pushes the envelope as far as getting your fish to bulk up quicker than if you use the AquaMax and the locally produced fish feed, right? It's a feed where tilapia grabs at anything that falls in the water, right? So although I've actually changed to AquaMax for a while, even if I actually, let's say, drop this in the water, they will grab at it, right? So chicken feed is the same thing. Okay, so here is the downside with feeding your tilapia chicken feed. One, your water will become like this within a day, and it will even get worse, looking something like this but more whiter by the evening, and eventually, give it about probably 3 days, your pond will start to stink, literally stink. So as to make this practice of feeding tilapia fish actually work, you would need a much heavier filtration system than I have, right? So as to filter out the fragments of the feed when they are actually left floating in the water. Now this feed actually dissolve in the water within less than a minute, right? Within less than a minute, this feed dissolves in the water. However, chicken feed dissolving in the water less than a minute, probably about 20-30 seconds. The only thing that is left standing is a corn in the chicken feed, right? So number one issue is that it pollutes the water very quickly, and you're gonna have to do something about that. And in doing something about that, you're talking about, it's either you're gonna be changing your water very regularly, which is an expense, or you add an additional layer of filtration system within your pond system, which is another expense, because you're gonna still have to pull down the filtration system and service that filtration system more often than if you have a normal filtration system. Alright? Two, you'll find that if you are having, like, let's say that you're keeping, these are juveniles, right? Juveniles still up there. And you have mixed stock like I do. That means you're expecting to have babies, right? What I realize is that using chicken feed, the babies do come, but they do not come that in that abundance as if you'll be feeding them the fish feed itself. It is unsure as to whether or not the pH of the water actually cause the fish to actually die, that's the babies, or is it that they are unable to fertilize the eggs because of, you know, the water is just not good. And the frequency in changing water can stir up the whole process of fertilization and mating and all that, because, you know, the more the water change, you know, the fish is stressed, so therefore the breeding probably might be a little out of whack. So three things here that I find a problem with feeding your tilapia from chicken feed. One, the water gets polluted very quickly. Two, you need a heavy filtration system. Three, the quantity decreases. They do reproduce, but the quantity decreases. And four, the colors of your tilapia is not all that bright. I have been feeding these fish AquaMax for the past couple of weeks, right? And I can see very much the colors are really looking really nice, right? It's not like pinkish whitish, it's more like reddish dark pink, and I like that, right? And I shared in a video before on the whole idea of, you know, red tilapia, which is different from red Nile tilapia. And I spoke to you regarding, you know, the fact that you have roughly three main strain of red tilapia. If you are for it, I'm not really a person that right now. But as a result of those negative implications, let's get back to the topic, right? As a result of that negative implication, I opted to, you know, after a few weeks, stop using chicken feed and go back to my normal fish feed. Although the normal fish feed do cloud the water, do mess up the water, and have issues, water do get stink, but the quickness in that happening with the locally produced tilapia fish feed is not as the chicken feed itself, although they look the same, right guys? I hope that this do help. Yeah, as I said before, some persons, you know, have really sophisticated backdoor tilapia system. This is just for academic purpose and for my own personal use. I do sell fingerlings at times, but right now I'm not, because, you know, I need some babies, right? So I'm not selling right now. It's a little bit cool, so they are not reproducing, and, you know, cichlids usually reproduce when it is a little bit warm. Thank you very much for stopping by, guys. Have a wonderful day. Peace out. Catch you next time. Bye bye.